Hello again, and welcome to part two of the analytics video. In part one, we looked at data and analytics, crunching numbers, and also using some of those visualization techniques which are embedded in the library for analytics. In this second part, I'm going to have a look at algorithms, so how we can detect whether things are going wrong with the plant automatically and look for abnormal conditions and so on, which is perhaps the sort of classic understanding of analytics when applied to an HVAC system. This station I've got on the screen in front of me now has a few fake bits of plant set up in it. None of this is real, but you can see there's a bunch of fan coil units. They've all got their own little graphic. They should all be behaving similarly but slightly differently in most parts. So the valves open and close, the heating and cooling valves open and close, and you'll see some overlap, some don't. So we've actually got faults we can look for. That's the purpose behind this. Now the analytic I'm going to put in today will look for heating and cooling coils both open by more than 10% simultaneously. Quite a simple one. There's a few other examples we could put in there. And in fact, this particular example is one of the ones which is in the library already. So if you open the Palette Analytics library, you will see there's a simultaneous heating and cooling algorithm already in there. Although it's much more complicated than what I'm about to show you, because I'm going to keep this nice and simple. All of these are tagged appropriately. So all of these things are tagged up with tags I know and I'm familiar with. And if we look at the tag manager, I can probably show you that fairly easily. So yeah, you can see the various fan coils and floors and so on. If we start populating this, you'll see what's in here. There we go. So we've got return temps. It's given a floor and an SCU number so I can identify them uniquely. That's supply temp. And if we look at the valves themselves, Z colon heating valve, Z colon cooling valve. As I said, I've kept it relatively simple. At the moment, there are no analytics set up and there are no alerts set up. We have to do both of those in order to make this work. So I'll start with the algorithm. So we'll just create one new one. And the idea is we'll use one algorithm throughout the entire station and then target the specific floors using the alerts. So, but it's the reuse of the algorithm which is important. If I give this a good name, sim heat cool, not a great name, but it'll do. Okay. Now, it looks a bit like a normal wire sheet. But in actual fact, this is quite specialised. Any blocks that go on here, you'll see they have this little cog in the corner. You can't use standard pieces of Niagara Framework blocks in here. So things like the numeric blocks and so on. You have to pick them from this palette here, which is the analytics palette. The first thing you always need is a data source block. So this is where we pick up the data we want to operate on for us. So for us, it's this heating and the cooling valves. And it's always tag driven. So in here it will be heating valve. That's all I nearly need in there right now. So we'll just leave it at that. Duplicate that one. And this one is obviously the other side, cooling. And we'll need that piece of information there, correcting. So that's our two source bits of data from the station. As I said, both driven by tags. Fairly simple, and it will just look everywhere in the station for these things. Now, there is something I should have mentioned earlier, perhaps, and that is everything I want to have used in the analytics has another tag in it, a special tag, which is this A colon A, A analytics. Now, you can have the analytics piece put that in for you automatically, and there is a setting in the analytics service. If I show you that. Here, auto tag analytic point. If you set that to true, it will add that AA when it feels it needs to, i.e. if you're picking up something in the analytics engine. I've left mine to full so it doesn't tag everything. So then I can specifically include or preclude things from my analytics algorithms. It's up to you which one you actually do. The next thing I need is a constant. Step band is not really, but it'll be anything that's between. So I want to know if both of those valves are open more than, let's say, 10% at any time. Now, obviously, there would be other perhaps mitigating factors when you do the algorithm. So for example, frost protection and so on may actually legitimately demand these two things to be open. So you would need a more complicated algorithm than I'm using here. It's just this is a good example to start with. The next thing I want for my particular purpose here is a switch. So this particular one is going to be greater than or equal to. So I want a yes it is if the heating valve is greater than or equal to 10% open. Now I also want to know exactly that same bit of information for the cooling valve. So we'll do the same thing, just duplicate it in this particular instance. Now for my analytic, I need both of those things to be true for this to be a problem. So both valves open more than 10%. So we have one final switch by switch block, and this point it's going to be and. So both of them are open. We just feed both of those in. Oops, both of those in there. Final bit you always have to have is to link to the result block for that algorithm. So there we go, that's our algorithm done. The next stage is to build some alerts. Now I've got three floors. I'm going to target each floor specifically with an alert. So I can I could in theory put different alarms out, which you'll see in a second. So we'll make three. So the first one, perhaps unsurprisingly, is floor one. Second one is floor two. And the third one, surprise, surprise, floor three. For these, they're all going to be the same. So I'm going to pick up my algorithm here. So alg sim cool, hemp sim heat cool. It is the same for each one. And now for floor one, I want to go to floor one. So this sets the scope for that particular algorithm. It's only going to look from that folder down. And I want to do this so that I can be a little bit more picky about perhaps where the alarms go or some such, which you'll see soon. I could just have one big alert system, of course, but I'm going to be a bit more targeted than that. I'm going to ignore all of these extra states because I am dealing with fakey plants, so I am going to be overriding things on and off and so on. So we just hit OK. Now, each one of these, we can do a find related data on it, and it should go away and do exactly what I've just asked it to, i.e. find related data. So if I come back in here, the break view, you can see there's the algorithm, cooling valve, heating valve. I'm just going to double check that I've used the right tag. I have. That's good. I started to worry I'd use the wrong tag. Now, I've also set up various different polars on here, so I'm going to set them all to this fast polar, which actually works every 15 seconds. So it's going to go out and ask the question every 15 seconds. That would not necessarily be a smart thing to do on a large system or a real system, because you could well end up flooding the network with comms. It's okay when it's just looking through the station, but I'd use a bit of caution on anything where there's a real danger you could flood the network with comms. And what I will do is just to kick it all off. We'll get the analytics service to refresh the cache. Now, if we look here, if you double click on alerts, we've actually got a little summary of what's going on. And you can see already there's five nodes it's picking up, and there are some alerts already being generated. Now, I didn't enable alarms, which I probably should have done. So if we enable the alarms, they're going to go to the default alarm class. We'll do that on all of them. Oops. It would have been smart to do that first, but never mind. So if we look on floor one as a little summary, you can see that that one, the valves are both genuinely open, and in fact on that one. So we had several reports from that one. There's three alerts, in fact. I'm going to guess one of these others probably also crossed over, maybe there, or possibly this one, don't know. Floor two, we've got the same summary. Now, if I remember rightly, those were all behaving correctly, although one of them is stuck fully open. And floor three. Oops, I should open both of them then. Which has also got valves presumably stuck open. So if we go find those. I think that one is FCU11, in fact. So they are both stuck open. So if we put those back into auto, we'll clear the fault. And the same was true of floor one, if I remember rightly. So we got FCU3 and 1. So we'll clear those as well. And you can see the alerts clearing as we go. Now, if we go and have a look at the alarms, you'll see what sort of things get reported. So they should all come into here. And it's all cleared at the moment. That is the default alarm class. Now, if I go and quite deliberately ruin something, so we'll go for 86 for a minute, 87, sorry, for a minute, and 4 for a minute. That will obviously give us our alert. If I look on here, you should hopefully see there. It's gone into alert. If we look on here, there we go, FCU11, floor 3, fault. So you see the source is actually quite specific. It does tell me exactly where that's gone wrong. But if I want to funnel the alarms out into specific alarm classes, I can. And that is pretty much it for today. So I hope that is of some use. There are some 50-odd examples in the alarm in the analytics library. You can use these as you see fit. You can see how they're all assembled, and hopefully the little demo I've just given you will give you some idea as to how these pieces actually all slot together. One piece I will specifically mention is a sliding window. Very useful, but quite difficult to give you a demonstration about it without us hanging around waiting for 30 minutes for something to go wrong. So if I wish to use that, and for example, if I wish to time that both the coils are open for longer than 10 minutes, then I would have the results feeding into this sliding window to just basically check my understanding. And I could do that too with the stuck valves. So if they're at anything over 50%, for longer than an hour, let's say we could say that that is perhaps stuck. So the sliding window is an incredibly useful block to have in there. As I said, I hope that was useful. I've tried to keep it as brief and as simple as I possibly could. So I hope, as I say, that was of some use, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.